Deputy Speaker, sir, air quality regulation and actions for abatement of air pollution are undertaken under various provisions of Air Act and Environment Protection Act, which prescribes the mechanism and authorities for handling the issues. In Delhi and NCR, there is a peculiar situation. In order to abate and control air pollution in Delhi and NCR, MOEFCC has undertaken several initiatives besides strengthening the ongoing national level as well as city-specific activities on abatement of air pollution. A high-level task force was constituted under the chairmanship of Principal Secretary to the PM for the management of air pollution in Delhi and NCR in November 17. The high-level task force closely monitors the implementation of measures related to management of air pollution in Delhi and NCR. Further regular review meetings have held with all concerned central government ministries, state governments under chairmanship of Honorable Minister, that is, I have conducted it, and Harshvardhan ji earlier, as well as Secretary EFCC to ensure that various measures of prevention, control and abatement of air pollution in Delhi and NCR are taken in coordinated and effective manner. A comprehensive air plan for Delhi NCR has been developed, identifying the timelines and implementing agencies for actions delineated. The central government has notified a graded response action plan for Delhi and NCR for different levels of pollution. The nature, scope, rigor of measures to be taken is linked with the levels of pollution, namely severe plus or emergency. Severe, very poor, moderate to poor, and moderate, after due consideration by the authorities concerned, the actions are to be implemented in the entire NCR throughout the year. For management of air pollution in Delhi and NCR, source-based approach has been adopted by the government to control air pollution, which gets aggravated during winter months. Major sources contributing air pollution are industry, vehicles, road and soil dust, construction and demolition, biomass and garbage burning, etc. As per continuous ambient quality monitoring stations data, there is general improvement in air quality of Delhi in last 3 years. The good and satisfactory or moderate days, which were 106 in 2016, have improved to 152, now to 159, and I am happy to tell that out of 324 days of this year, 175 days are in this category. And the bad air days have gone down from 246 to 213 to 206 to this year's 190 days out of 324. So, this is very important. Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has launched National Clean Air Program in January 29 to tackle the problem of air pollution in comprehensive manner, with targets to achieve 20-30% reduction in PM10 and PM2.5. concentrations by 2024, keeping 2017 as the base. The plan includes 102 non-attainment cities across 23 states and union territories on the basis of their ambient air quality data between 2011 and 2015. Non-attainment cities are those which have been consistently showing poorer air quality than the national ambient air quality. Various committees have been constituted at centre, steering committee headed by secretary, a joint secretary, an implementation committee under member secretary CPCB. The states have further directed to consider these committees at state level also. To help the states, UTs implement the action plans, this ministry is collaborating under a national clean air program with state pollution control boards and leading academic institution in the state for which MOUs have been signed. The ministry has designated IIT Kanpur as the nodal academic institution to coordinate with all other IITs and other leading universities. Ministry has allocated 10 crore each for 28 cities, that is 280 crores, for million plus populations, for public awareness, capacity building, source apportionment study, mechanical street sweeper, water sprinklers, mobile enforcement units. This is important because acknowledging the problem is the beginning of solution of the problem. And therefore, tree plantation, greening activities, and many other activities with the state and city funds also. The construction and demolition waste management facility for the remaining non-attainment cities, fund of 10 lakh per city for cities with population less than 5 lakh and 20 lakh for cities between 5 and 10 lakh is also given. So that is 172 crores. A number of initiatives have been taken. First is the vehicle pollution. We are now migrating to BS6. This will reduce pollution by 80%, vehicular pollution by 80%. And this BS6 migration has already happened for fuel in Delhi, but vehicles also will be BS6 compliant from April 2020. Then operationalization of eastern and western peripheral expressway. In Delhi, there used to be 60,000 trucks every day polluting the Delhi city, though they had no work in Delhi. But now they don't enter into Delhi because these two bypass roads are ready and are being used. So that has reduced the pollution to a great extent. Introduction of cleaner alternative fuel like gasoline fuel, CNG, LPG with ethanol blending. And as we know, we have also flown a flight from ethanol. In Delhi, about 500 new CNG stations have been established. Use of RFID tag has also helped. And network of metro, now 77 kilometers, 274 stations, and 5 million passengers every day. That's huge public transport, which is environmental friendly. To promote electrical vehicles, we are giving subsidies, and we have sanctioned 300 new buses for Delhi and 100 buses for DMRC. Permit requirement for electrical vehicles has been done away with. Promotion of public transport and improvement in the roads, and you are seeing millions of, now lakhs of e-rickshaws. Industrial emissions, this is important. Stringent emission norms for coal-based thermal power plants that has reduced the coal power thermal pollution. Badarpur thermal power station has been closed. Pet coke and furnace oil has been banned. Out of 4,700 industrial units in Delhi, 2,600 units have shifted to PNG, and new units will be allowed to shift to LPG. Installation of online continuous monitoring station, monitoring system for polluting industries, and that we are controlling every minute. Revision of emission standards of SOx and NOx for boilers have been introduced. About 2,800 brick kilns have been converted to zigzag technology, because that is very important, and that has reduced the pollution to a great extent. Crop residue management, that's an important issue of stubble burning, and the biomass burning in the city itself also. A new central sector scheme on promotion of agriculture mechanization in situ management, states of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and NCT of Delhi, for the period of 18-20, 1,151 crores have been sanctioned. More than 50,000 machines have already been given. The reversible MB plow, paddy straw chopper, mulcher, rotary slasher, zero till seed drill, and rotavators are promoted with 50% subsidy to the individual farmers and 80% subsidy to custom hiring centers for this machine. And 56,290 machines to the individual farmers have already been given, and hiring centers have been given. And during 1920, we are supplying 46,000 new machines. With the efforts of government overall, about 15 to 41% reduction in burning events were observed in 2018. Compared to 2017 and 2016, and during 1920 season, a total burning events have recorded in the states are 19% less than 18, and as on 18th November, and यूपी हैज रिकॉर्डेड 36% रिडक्शन, हरियाणा रिकॉर्डेड 25% रिडक्शन, पंजाब रिकॉर्डेड 16% रिडक्शन रिस्पेक्टिवली, बिकॉज दिस इज नॉट स्विच ऑन स्विच ऑफ जॉब, सो इट टेक्स टाइम बट वी आर प्रोग्रेसिंग. सॉलिड वेस्ट नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ सिक्स सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट रूल इंक्लूडिंग प्लास्टिक वेस्ट, सॉलिड वेस्ट, ई वेस्ट, बायोमेडिकल वेस्ट, कंस्ट्रक्शन डिमोलिशन वेस्ट, हजार्डस वेस्ट have been issued, and now extended producer responsibility is now also being implemented. Ban on burning of biomass and garbage has been posted. 3 waste to energy plants producing 52 megawatts of electricity per day by burning 5000 plus tons of waste is an important development. A 200 tons per day waste to compost plant is also operational. Bioremediation and biomining of landfill sites at Ghazipur and others is also progressing now, and number of mechanized road sweeping, there are 60 machines in Delhi now. SOPs and notification, construction and demolition waste. We made first time the rules of construction and demolition waste, and I am happy to report that 3 CD waste processing plants with 2,650 tons per day capacity are operational, and about 2 lakh tons of end product, that is tiles, dividers and paver blocks, have been produced in these factories. Monitoring, notification of national ambient air quality, because as I said, the recognition of the problem is the start of solution of the problem, and therefore in 2015 Prime Minister launched air quality index. Now we are monitoring 793 locations in 344 cities. Therefore, we know what is the pollution level in each city at each minute. Implementation of air quality early warning system in Delhi in October 18 in association with Ministry of Earth Science is already in place. Then there are technical intervention. Pilot projects were deployed in Delhi for evaluation of air pollution mitigation technologies. Ambient air purification through wind augmentation and purification, that is Vayu, for pollution abatement at traffic intersections like ITO and Madar intersections was done, and filtration units on 30 buses was also evaluated. It is a mixed result, but everything needs to be tried and pilot project needs to be done. Application of dust suppressant. Effectiveness of the dust suppressant lasted about 6 hours, after which it had to be reapplied. About 30% reduction in dust concentrations was observed up to 6 hours. Advisory has been issued to state boards to use dust suppressant. It's a chemical. Last 2 points. Research projects are being carried out by CPCB in collaboration with the premier institutes like IIT Miri under Environment Protection Charge Funds. Lack of certification system of ambient air quality monitoring instrument of India was identified, and now that certification scheme will be undertaken by National Physical Laboratory. Regular engagement with technical bodies and experts have been undertaken for knowledge sharing. But as I tell, despite everything, still there is a still problem, because it has started 20 years ago, it became severe every year. And I appeal to everybody to give, we need cooperation of everybody and suggestions also from this house.